How is it going, ladies and gentlemen? This is the Wolf Around, and it's great to see you here. In this video, I'll show you how to compile Python from its source code. Subscribe to the channel, join the pack, you are always welcome here. Without further ado, let's get started. There are several reasons you might need to compile Python from its source code. Maybe you want to test the latest Python versions, or the libraries you use may not be compatible with the pre-installed default Python version on your Linux system. For example, I'm using Debian 12, which comes with Python 3.11 pre-installed. When Python 3.11 was first released, many libraries like PyTorch weren't compatible with it. To use these libraries, I needed to install an older version of Python. Compiling Python from source offers flexibility. You can install any Python version, install it anywhere you want, remove it whenever you like. I've written a base script to automate this process and make it easier to explain. The script will check for required dependencies one by one. If a dependency is missing, it will install it and set the installation directory you specify. You can choose the Python version by its major, minor, and patch numbers. For instance, you can choose versions like 3.10.8 or 3.6.6. In this tutorial, I'll compile Python 3.13.1. The script checks if the Python source code archive is already downloaded. If it isn't, it will download it using wget. You can visit the official Python download page to choose the version you want to install. In this example, we'll use version 3.13.1. After downloading, the script decompresses the archive, if not already decompressed, and navigates into the decompressed directory. Before configuration, a special linker flag, vlrpath, is defined. This flag allows the linker to remember the library path so that it can link dependencies automatically, even if the path isn't in the system's LD library path variable. Make sure to include the enabled shared option in the configuration to generate libraries during compilation. You can consider these as equivalent of installing Python 3 dev packages for your pre-installed Python. You can change the installation directory if needed. For instance, you can install Python under usr local, but in this case, make sure to use the sudo make all to install command to avoid conflicts with the system's default Python version. Here are the important configuration options. Enable optimization. Enables all required compile time optimizations. With LTO, enables link time optimizations across all translation units. This provides extra performance at runtime but increases compilation time. I don't recommend using it if you are compiling Python temporarily. Prefix sets the installation directory. The script detects your computer's maximum thread count and uses two fewer threads for the compilation. Since I'm recording this tutorial, I reduced the thread count further and disabled with LTO. To run the script, type sh compile python sh in the terminal. It will prompt for your sudo password to install dependencies. Wait for the compilation to complete. By the way, I'll share this script in the description. But the next steps are important. I'll explain how to use your custom Python installation. Once the compilation is complete, you'll notice that pip is installed alongside the custom Python interpreter. Navigate to the bin folder where the Python executable is located. And the lib folder, which contains shared libraries. We need to add the bin folder to the path variable for terminal access. Open bashrc file using nano. Scroll to the end. And add the lines I'm typing to add the bin folder to the path. Instead of using vlrpath flag, you could add the lib folder to the ldlibrarypath variable as an alternative. Save the file by pressing Ctrl+S, close it, and refresh the terminal using source bashrc command. To run your custom Python installation, type the version you compiled. Since I chose Python 3.13, I need to type Python 3.13 to run my custom Python installation. Typing Python 3 will still run the default Python version installed on your system. The same logic applies to pip as well. If you type just pip 3, the default Python's pip will run. But if you type pip 3.13, the custom Python installation's pip will run. Run pip 3.13 version command to see where the packages will be installed. Let me open this directory in the file manager as well. Now, when I install NumPy using pip 3.13, the NumPy package will be installed here. You can see the installed NumPy package folders in the file manager window. You can list installed packages using pip 3.13 list command too. I'm a software engineer specializing in computer graphics, game development, GPU hardware acceleration, AI inference, and cross-platform C++ development, and I look forward to sharing more insights with you. Please like, subscribe, and leave a comment. I'll see you in the next one.